What's up, people? VanTXA9 here at ringside, and welcome back to SmackDown vs. Raw. This part is live, and well, I decided to actually drop in with, I decided to change things up and actually put the background music back on. It's now on minimum, so hopefully that will avoid any copyright, and, well, because I'm going to be talking over most of it, yeah, that can also kind of help out. So, last time, if my memory is correct, I can't exactly remember, because this was actually between some stuff. Anyway, yeah, we're Chris Jericho, and I've won the Intercontinental Championship, and I am currently at 93. I am going to, probably have already told what I'm going to be doing here. I'm going to be doing four runs through season mode, because you have four different types of storylines that you can handle. So I will be doing the title holder run for Jericho. Yeah, just to reiterate, and not to mention so I can actually know to put that in post commentary. But this is live, so let's go. June 3rd week on Raw. From time to time, which I'm probably actually going to point out in the first couple parts, I will actually have a co-commentator. I don't know, it just feels kind of hollow not having any music on, considering I've actually played through these with the music on. So, yeah. Alright, so what's the GM guy say? I've already kind of played ahead to kind of regain a feel for it, but still. I don't know. It's been a while since I played the original. Probably gonna say that again. But anyway, storyline time. Let's go.
You know, I was looking at last week's ratings, and the highest rated segment of the show was the grudge match between the champ and his choice of opponents.
All right, now I remember.
So tonight, we're going to have a non-title triple threat match between the champion and both opponents.
Oh, goody.
And if the champ should not win tonight's triple threat, then he'll defend his title against tonight's winner this Sunday at Bad Blood.
Okay, but what if I win? Then what? Come on, this is still going to be a title defense. I mean, it's got to. I mean, granted, it's not the world championship, but still. You know what? Whatever. Doesn't matter. Alright, so me versus Christian versus Shawn Michaels. I still want to know why Christian. By the time that this game came out, Christian was still a mid-carder. He wasn't actually main event material. It wasn't until they finally gave him a shot after his run in TNA that he actually did become championship material. But whatever. And what's up with all of the... Seriously, I have to point this out because I probably won't remember to say it before. What is it with these freaking matches having no disqualifications? Specifically the championship matches. That's kind of freaking stupid. And God, I'm having such a nostalgia rush off of this. Seeing all these old superstars here. To be honest, I'm actually going to be skipping entrances, and probably during run two, I'm actually going to take them out. The only time I'm actually really going to keep them is if something important happens. And yes, sometimes something does happen during your entrance, or during someone else's. You know, whether they get assaulted, or whether or not somebody else is coming out as like a special guest referee, or they're getting ready to run interference, or something else. Oh wait, yeah, and then what I just said, I'm sorry, I have to go back and amend what I said. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out why Christian is in this. I forgot, I'm IC champion, not world heavyweight champion. Shit. See, I kind of forgot because I played ahead, so I did some other stuff. And like I said, you have to have a rating of 85 or higher in order to even qualify as a contender for the world title. Kind of a foregone conclusion what I'm doing, isn't it? I'm going for the world championship. I'm building my way up there. Good God, that belt looks so damn fake. There's like such a weird texture here. I don't know. It's kind of odd to actually see Jericho in this game and then play some of the later ones and he's not there. But it's good that he actually did go on and have his time off so that he could kind of, you know, come down from it and not really get stale. And that's what some people really need.
Alright,
now I should be able to remember how to play now. The unfortunate thing with this game, which I probably might not actually mention in part one, but I don't know. I just want to point it out again, is that you don't really have a whole lot of momentum. I mean, you have too much momentum, is what I'm trying to say. You can actually really get kind of caught up with, you can continue to do moves repeatedly at no cost. In essence, you can spam a whole bunch of submissions or damaging moves like I'm about to do right now.
I'd hate to be that referee,
you know, see, I can keep working on HBK's legs. By the time he actually goes for that sweet chin music, yeah, he won't be able to actually successfully go. Damn it, Christian, you would be the first one to go get a weapon. Fine, I'll go get me something, and I'm going to work on you. I'm going to unpretty your ass. Oh, man, he went down already.
Even if you can't,
it does feel pretty
him,
bad,
you got to respect,
you know,
Shawn Michaels' accomplishments
like this. So let's see what we can do here. Damn, we got a nice counter on me though. Damn, what's up with that? Oh, with that drop. What? Oh,
it was only a matter
right,
of time
my indicator wasn't on
like
Christian
that.
It was on HBK. Damn, alright, fine. I don't like the submission system in this game. It really sucks. You can easily get a quick submission if your timing is poor. I mean, well, your opponent can get a quick submission. But fine. No time to taunt, dude. You're in a triple threat match. I almost forgot about that. Yeah, the whole TLC concept. The
ability.
Dudleys with the tables, the Hardys with the ladders, and Edge and Christian with the chairs. Okay, now, try this.
If he takes too
oh,
many
crap, the DDT.
Moves,
shit.
He might as well pack
nah, bro.
It in.
One. No, you don't. Break that shit up right now. Ooh, and Jericho with the steel step. Oh, and there goes HBK. Oh, crap. Stop it. I hate those cruiserweight moves. I really do, because they're like a waste of time and energy. Oh, crap. I really shouldn't actually be going up high anyway, but damn, I didn't expect to do that. Christian, quit copying, man.
Have you ever seen superstars lay into each other the way these guys are?
Yes! He's down. Ooh! That headshot. Ooh! To be honest, I actually prefer to wrestle for real, but these guys are just full of it. See, this is like one of the last games where you can actually throw weapons.
But he's not afraid to get physical either.
Oh, Lord, I hate that. Those glitches. What? And then... Oh. I thought I would have been kick-ass about it. Just, like, get him with that. Yeah, in fact, you know what? I'm just going to let them duke it out. That's kind of one of the good things about the AI in the early games, is that they're kind of stupid and they don't pay attention at all. Bitch! Get off him.
These guys have done their homework on each other, JR.
Do this. What the? Oh, he could have went for an unprettier if he actually had the finisher. Nick. Michaels. Fine, you know what? This. Submission! Like,
oh,
you over
gosh.
There getting your dang
he's
weapon.
Got it locked in. Can he get it to tap out?
I would have actually set him up. Stop it. Oh, no. Unprettier. Oh, shit. Damn. Christian, you suck. He's not going to get a pin off me, though. My health is still in the blue. Now, if I wanted to be pro, I would actually take off the name tags and stuff. You know, so then I just pretty much have to play off my own skill. You know, okay, I think I've worn him down enough. Now, I can do that crap in exhibition matches. I'd actually prefer to see what I'm doing here. I'm going to try and actually legitimately wrestle for the most part, but if I can actually get over on my opponent, rest assured, I'm getting over on my opponent with some cheap attacks. Christian, you want some table too? Yep. Time for the super dirty.
These competitors are some of the greatest athletes you'll find in any sport.
Hey, look, can you see straight? Ooh, now you can't, bitch.
Ouch.
Christian, what up? Ah. You're going, let's get you. Hey, how you doing? I like how that actually knocked him flat the hell out. There he goes with these damn cruiserweight moves again. Did Michaels even really do these all that much in his matches? See, and yeah, some people are probably going to be like, well, you ought to try and wrestle the matches like how they really do. Yeah, good luck with that, because when you actually watch the computer do it, oh, good God, they don't even wrestle like they do on TV. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. See, I'm so used to the fact that the later games actually switched it so that the interaction button is actually X and the strike button is actually square. What am I doing again? Run. That's how you get up there. Oh. Damn, you missile drop kick.
Dang, he got him. I don't think this one's about winning or losing anymore. I think it's more personal than that.
The father of the boy who doesn't win. Wait. I don't know. I was just thinking that for no reason. So get you in the... Dang it, Michaels. I was running, but I wasn't running towards you. See, sometimes like the funniest glitches will happen in this game, though. Oh, the chat. Whoa, what the hell? All right. Christian.
These guys are writing a wrestling textbook in the ring, JR.
Mm-hmm.
You shouldn't be taunting him, JR. Keep your words soft and sweet in case you have to eat him later.
Uh-oh.
I don't think he's going to be able to break that hole, JR. He's going to have to tap out.
Dude. Ooh, look at that suplex. Steal it. Sweet chin music. Boom. Old kid and Kabula. Make it get. Oh, come on, Christian. See, you know, while he's still reeling from the sweet chin music, yeah, I could have actually got him with the Balls of Jericho, which I'm planning on doing, but sometimes the computer won't let you get what you want. Damn, another dude busted open. Oh, no, you don't. HBK, go to... Damn it, I hate that. It'll let you free target the referee. That's not what I want. This match is taking way too damn long. Seriously.
In all my years of sports entertainment, I've never seen superstars with more potential. Remind me to never try and step between these guys, JR.
Stop that. Stop it. Stop it, both of you. Here we go. Pile driver.
Now he's gotta
follow up
and build some
Walls
momentum.
Of Jericho. Now.
And the crowd on your side, the match.
Although I think rope breaks are in this match, so come on. Fuck! There's no point unless you just want to build momentum and continue to hurt your opponent. Bulldog. Fuck yeah. Steal it. One, two. Damn it.
What an incredible performance.
See, that's kind of the bad thing. Some of these matches will actually be like, they'll almost run as if it's on hard difficulty. So it'll make it. Nigga, this ain't the Royal Rumble? Shit.
He's cocky for
sure. Sometimes they'll actually make a match pretty hard without actually being on hard mode or legend mode, you know? And that'll actually make the match kind of difficult to deal with. You can actually really get caught up. See, look what you did. The damn table was in the way.
See,
those glitches, that collision detection. It treated as if the whole table was actually straight across him instead of just that little corner. And it cost him the match. Oops. In some cases, it doesn't even matter whether you actually win or not. What the hell? Chris Benoit. Dude, what the...
Seems like you don't have a challenger for your title match, champ. That belt is driving you insane. And someone's got to take it away from you for your own good. So I just came in from the GM's office. And since you won this triple threat match, it turns out that the new number one contender is me.
Oh, shit.
Did you hear that? We'll have a title match this Sunday at Bad Blood After All.
Well, who didn't see that coming? And this is going to really get like some... This is going to be really fucking awkward. I said that at the beginning of this storyline, that this was going to be very awkward. I have nothing to say. Well, I do have something to say, but I'm not going to say it. You know, we'll just leave it at that. Some things best need not be said. So we're running at about 16 minutes. I think we can actually still get a match off. So let's go for it, shall we? Bad Blood. Let's do it. I would save, but I actually trust my abilities. And not to mention, in this game, every damn championship match that you are in is a no disqualification match. Seriously, no disqualifications whatsoever. And that is incredibly stupid because it just makes it that much easier. All you gotta do is just go outside, either pick up the belt or pick up a chair and proceed to beat the hell out of your opponent, and that's the end of the match.
We're here tonight, live on pay-per-view at Bad Blood. Jim Ross here with Jerry, the King Lawler at ringside. And King, what a show we've got tonight.
Good Lord, this setup was real stupid looking back then.
A lot of great matches planned for tonight, JR. But I think the main event's gonna steal the show.
Usually that's the whole point of the main event, King.
The Intercontinental title is on the line tonight. Folks, you don't want to miss this one.
Yeah, so I'm probably actually going to start uploading SmackDown vs. Raw pretty soon. So kind of points out, you know, I guess I could kind of like point that out that, yeah, basically, at this point, I've pretty much taken to playing SmackDown vs. Raw, and Tenkaichi 3 is the last Dragon Ball Z game I'm going to be playing for a while. Why can't you see the fucking announcers? Where'd they go? Yeah. Good God, why is it so damn awkward? I mean, you know, I don't want to see any fucking comments, okay? Nothing that that has to do with that, all right? I'm probably going to actually put up a little subtitle in the earlier videos, too. Because, well, we don't need to fucking talk about it, do we? Do we really actually need to talk about it? There's no point in talking about it. What happened, happened. You know, it's unfortunate that it happened. The circumstances that led to it, God damn it, I'm talking about it. See, this is what I meant. Let's not talk about it. Although I don't approve of the WWE pretty much just like blowing him out of the history and the records and shit, considering he was the first man to actually jump ship, utilizing that loophole in the Royal Rumble winner contract. But okay, because several other people have done it since then. You know, and then, of course, there was that historic night, you know, finally won the world championship while Guerrero actually successfully defended the WWE championship. These guys entered into this promotion at the same time in the same stable. And now, finally, the last two that were there won the championship. And then there's that cruel irony in that they're both dead now. Yeah, that is pretty fucked up. That's all that I gotta say about it. Now, let's get to the match.
A big bienvenue to our fans around the world.
Was one of the best damn technical wrestlers ever.
Montreal, Quebec. Jim Ross here with Jerry McKee.
See, and now I'm distracted folks, because I can't stop thinking about it.
Let me just assure you that tonight's show is a lot better than JR's bridge.
Sheesh. Get down.
Well, this is it. The championship is on the line.
And Jericho's mostly dirty. He's rarely ever a good guy. Unless, of course, you know, you're in Canada. And then he actually is. Because of bizarre world there. I don't know why they had to be heels here in the States anyway.
There's a lot of pride on the line here.
They're pretty good.
And nobody wants to go back to the locker room as the loser.
These guys are beating the heck out of each other. And this crowd can't get enough of it.
Already going for the chair. I don't really approve of that. God damn it. Stop giving me material. Literally, stop giving me material. And I'm already missing the other games for spoiling me and giving me the ability to do all this other crazy shit. So now I can pretty much like hit my opponent and do all this other crazy shit. You know, I can like put the chair on their leg and smash it. And oh wait, I'm over here spoiling it for those of you who haven't actually played these games yet. But yeah, they got better as time went on until 2008. Which is the like halfway point where it actually got better and worse at the same time. Chris. Don't chop me. No, take the heel to the face.
These guys have done their homework on each other.
See,
JR.
And they changed the way that the Irish whip system works too. So, yeah. I don't know who got that grapple. Okay. Whoa. See, here I am thinking, oh, he could go for his finisher right now. He has no momentum to do it.
This capacity.
I probably need to switch it from the direction pad to the.
I understand wanting to win a match, JR.
Ah,
but these guys are
and then I'm
going to
chain that
here.
With this. This wake up slap. And
my
now,
God.
Boom, pin with a bridge, rope break. That's fine. I just wanted to do damage to him. And that lion tamer, I'd love to be able to do that. Ugh. Work them arms, work them arms. No! Bin wall with the, aw, man. What the? Oh, no you don't.
Two.
I'll just stay out. No. Bulldog. Ah, he was getting ready to argue with the ref. Work that middle.
Benoit's trying to get him to wrestle his style of match. A technical mat.
Rear naked choke into a backbreaker. Boom. Walls of Jericho. Although we're awfully close to the ropes now.
Jericho's got the walls of Jericho locked.
So I have to rapidly press the hell out of these buttons in order to keep him from getting there. And because he's in the deep red, yeah, it makes it easy for him to submit. In the later games, they actually changed the submission system. So it's not that easy to bleed over. It's pretty much the same system that they used in Here Comes the Pain. It's just a bit looser.
The champion has retained
looser.
His title. My
More
God,
loose,
what a
whatever.
Match.
I don't know how we're going to follow that one up, JR.
That was actually rather quick. And that's the supposed end of that storyline, or at least that particular rivalry. Yeah, so we'll save. And that'll pretty much do for, what is this, part 3? Good God, these are going to be some long parts. Hopefully I can fit like 2 weeks into an episode, but whatever. Well, what is this? We'll have to find out in part 4.